Robin Lopez. 8 seconds left. Jeff Dalton penetrating in. 3 seconds left. Fadeaway jumper. Power. He throws it. Jeff Dalton Jr.
Hey, what's happening, everyone? This is Swish Culture. As soon as I uploaded my video on the Steph Curry and Avery Bradley deal, I discovered that the Golden State Warriors have signed Jeff Doughton to the remaining two-way slot. Thanks to Toby Reyes for the tip-off on that one. The Warriors have their first regular season game tomorrow, but the free agent market is still hotter than Jamaican jerk chicken. Now, if you were paying attention during Summer League, you know here at Swish Culture, Jeff Doughton was one of the players I thought would have been a great pickup for the Warriors if we had the space available. Of the Summer League players, he was one of the standouts that could contribute to the team in a secondary role, right along with Jacory McLaughlin. For you guys wondering why we didn't hold on to a player like Jessup, Jessup is signed to a contract in Australia for the coming year, and it would take a full NBA contract plus a buyout to get Jessup. Unless Jessup was ready to take a massive pay cut, and by massive I mean like maybe a few hundred K, along with the realization he's not going to be getting many minutes, he's not going to be coming stateside. Now, in the video I just posted regarding Steph and Avery Bradley, I mentioned that the Warriors are likely going to hold out for some young talent for the two-way spot, and this they did. Let me explain what this signing means for the Dubs, but first, be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and tap that notification bell to get all the latest Dub Nation updates. So the Warriors just claimed Jeff Doughton off waivers, and some of you may be wondering, who is Jeff Doughton? Doughton is a 6'3", 24-year-old point guard out of Rhode Island. He played for the Rhode Island Rams in college and averaged just under 14 points, 3.5 rebounds, and 3.2 assists in his senior year with the Rams. Over his college career, Doughton was able to average 36% from 3 and 45% from the field. Last year, in 2020, Doughton declared for the NBA draft, however, he went undrafted and decided to bet on himself in the G League with the Orlando Magic picking him up for their G League affiliate, the Lakeland Magic. In 15 games, Doughton averaged 6.5 points, 1.6 rebounds, and 2.5 assists in just under 20 minutes on the floor. While this isn't exactly top-notch performance, the Lakeland Magic did win the G League championship, which means that the roster he played on had some pretty decent talent that included Trey Jones, Luka Semenich, and Robert Woodard II, all players that are NBA level talent. Following this stint in the G League, he played for the Warriors Summer League team, averaging 17 points, 3.5 rebounds, and 4 assists in just under 23 minutes of playing time. While playing for the Dubs, Jeff played a much more significant role than he had in the past as a go-to scorer. After his two games in the California Classic ended and a great performance, Doughton returned to Orlando to play for the Magic Summer League team. On September 8th, he signed with the Orlando Magic but was waived shortly at the end of training camp. While this could otherwise mean that any team signing him should be cautious, for a two-way contract, he's a perfect fit. The Magic have a ton of young and talented point guards, starting with Markelle Fultz, Jalen Suggs, and Cole Anthony, plus RJ Hampton. It'll be tough finding any minutes for the players I just listed, who were all at some point ranked at the top of the lottery, so the Magic had no choice but to release Doughton. So, this waiving is no knock on Doughton's talent, but there just isn't enough room. Speaking of talent, what does Doughton bring to the team? Doughton, while he's a point guard, is a player that likes the ball in his hands and likes to score. I mean, he loves to score. He likes to get to his spots, and when he gets into a rhythm, he's deadly in the mid-range. In clutch moments, Jeff Doughton is a fearless competitor. He has no issues rising up to the challenge and doesn't get caught up in the moment. He can knock down shots in a hurry when he gets hot, and sometimes this is exactly what the team needs in a tough fourth quarter. While he's not a three-point specialist, he is competent shooting off the dribble and likes to get into a rhythm when taking his shots in front of or behind the arc. With the addition of Jeff Doughton, the Warriors now have very competent scoring ball handlers throughout the roster and in that two-way spot, unlike Chioza, who's a passing specialist. While this gives us a ton of offensive firepower, there does need to be a balance on the defensive end. The Warriors have the one spot remaining on their roster, and considering that the majority of the guards are scoring oriented, it seems they are leaning towards getting a player that is a defensive specialist for that 15th spot. This is another feather in Gary Payton's hat and is a very good sign for him, as there is no shortage of communications from Steve Kerr how much the team likes Payton and may be looking to bring him back. Until Klay comes back, the Warriors will likely have Poole alongside Steph to start in the backcourt. The second unit will likely have a combination of Doughton and Lee, and the third unit would be Chioza and Moody. We will likely see Moody and Lee switch places at times, or Lee and Poole depending on team needs and what matchups Kerr is trying to exploit. Lee and Moody have enough length and are committed enough on defense to help Chioza and Doughton on defense. Meanwhile, the combo of Wiggins, Draymond, and Looney balance out the backcourt of Poole and Curry. While this isn't exactly ideal, not having a defensive specialist to insert when we need it, this squad can still get the job done. With Porter Jr. and Bielitsa at the ready, we have a very flexible lineup that can be Draymond plus four shooters with Porter Jr. at small ball center without sacrificing much on defense. And a similar lineup can be run for the second unit as well, with Bielitsa in place of Porter Jr. playing minutes at the four alongside Looney. All in all, this is a great pickup for the Warriors, and it will be very interesting to see what Doughton can provide for the Dubs during their regular season. He has an opportunity, at least for the moment, considering Klay is out till December, and Wiseman being out as well means that guys will have to move up, increasing Jeff Doughton's role as the Warriors start out the season. Let me know in the comments below if you guys like the pick for the second two-way slot. If not, who would you rather have? Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and tap that notification bell to get all the latest Dub Nation updates. Till next time. King. Swish. Word, I'm a player, the real player. I don't give a prayer, man. A naysayer. I block so hard, sweetie, get served. Call me Lonzo Ball, bitches get swerved. Usually, I don't get down with you.